Now let's talk about this last kind of headwind of the unexpected. I said there were three. You know, sometimes the unexpected happens, personal life, professional life. I used to have to explain this, but now in the pandemic, everyone gets what I'm talking about, right? Because we've all been dealing with this. One of the hardest things I had to learn how to do was fly in turbulence. Now, here's what you're thinking. Nicole, you told me you were a fighter pilot for 10 years. Certainly you've flown in turbulence before. Yes, indeed I have. In fact, I was 12 years old when I started flying at North Las Vegas Airport, 16 years old when I soloed my first aircraft. So I had flown in turbulence a lot. Now, as an aviator, turbulence is a really fascinating thing. We have these weather models that can tell you when the atmosphere is ripe for turbulence. But we can never predict exactly where turbulence is going to happen, how severe it'll be, or how long that turbulence is going to last. Does that sound familiar to anybody right now, right? We've been in a pot of turbulence for the last 18 months. And I think that turbulence for me is that metaphor for the change and the adversity that we're going through. Now, I had flown in turbulence a lot, but my friends, the first time you encounter turbulence at 500 feet, 400 miles an hour, upside down, 3 feet away from other jets, I can assure you it is an eye-opening experience. So I was out over the deserts here of Las Vegas in this beautiful diamond formation on a blue sky and tailwind kind of day. I loved this formation. Remember, things were going well for me. I'm feeling strong. And boom, all of a sudden we hit turbulence, and instinctually, I gripped that stick as hard as I could, and I started to do what was not right. I started to try to fight the turbulence. I started to try to control the uncontrollable, and with each movement of the stick, the next bump in movement had to get bigger and bigger and bigger until I got into something called a PIO, or a pilot-induced oscillation. I can assure you it makes for a terribly ugly air show. It's definitely inefficient. And at the end of the day, it was downright dangerous. And when we landed that day after I was fighting and fighting and fighting, we got into the debrief. I knew we were going to talk about it. The number four pilot, the one on the far right, he's called the slot pilot. He's the one that flies underneath me and is dependent on me for his safety. He was a second-year experienced guy, Steve Horton. He said, Nicole, what were you doing out there? You were all over the place. You weren't adhering to the wingman contract. I couldn't fly underneath you. You were a mess. What was going on? And I said, bro, like, didn't you feel that turbulence? It was awful. And I'll never forget this moment. Steve Horton, right? I like to call him the man that sees all my mistakes, because he does. He looked at me and he laughed. And he said, oh, Nicole, we forgot to tell you the secret. Right? It's okay to laugh. I thought the same thing. I says, what? He says, we forgot to tell you the secret for staying in position when you encounter turbulence. Would you like to know the secret? I'm thinking, dude, that is information I could have used yesterday. Like, I would like to know the secret. He says, here's the secret. He says, we promise each other as teammates, no matter what position you're in, no matter what formation we're flying, no matter what maneuver we're about to do, we promise each other that the second any one of us encounters turbulence in our own jet, we will immediately loosen our grip. He leaned in and he says, you need to loosen your grip. Now, isn't that interesting? The exact opposite of my instincts as a pilot. And isn't that the exact opposite of our instincts as human beings when change and adversity comes along? Don't we want to try to fight it? Don't we waste a lot of energy on trying to control the uncontrollable? When we do that, it's a terribly inefficient use of your limited time, talent, and treasure. Loosen your grip. So the next day we go out and fly. It's blue sky and tailwind kind of day. I'm in the diamond formation and ba-boom, we hit the turbulence again, and I instinctually, my stomach tightens and I want to grip that stick so hard. But I thought, no, Steve Horton, he's like the Yoda of the team. So I'm like, loosen your grip. And I let go with one, two, three fingers. And I flew the jet just like this. And guess what happened? Yeah, I stayed in position. Each and every one of us did. The formation stayed in alignment, and ultimately we exited that turbulence intact as a team. And the beautiful thing is our customer, our client, the audience on the ground, they never even knew. In these hard times, it's okay to remind yourself and remind each other to control those things that you can, let go of those things that you can't. Fall back on those foundational trainings and syllabus, process, procedure. Ask for help from each other. Go to the basics. When you loosen your grip, that's how you get through the turbulence successfully, and that's how you stay together as a team. It's okay to loosen your grip.